Guys, I'm not going to lie to you. I am extremely tired today. However, we have 15 returns today. We have 7 small envelopes. We have 8 big 8x10 envelopes. This is my motivation to stay awake today. Let's open some more returns. All right, so for you newbies, this is going to be episode 2 of our through the mail autograph returns. I think last week we had 13 returns. Basically what TTM autographs is, it's through the mail. That's what TTM stands for. I send a famous athlete or celebrity a photo of themselves or a trading card of theirs. I send a letter of request to them, and then they return that card or photo signed back to me. And we're going to see if I was successful with that today. If you would like to learn how I do this, just let me know. I could do a tutorial on it. Pretty simple. Very inexpensive hobby. Super easy to get into. But today, like I said earlier, 7 small envelopes, 8 big envelopes. We're going to start off with the cards today. Notice how there's no flickering. We fixed our camera issue. All right, this first one's coming out of Seattle, Washington. Got our handy dandy Marlin spike. All right, first one of the day. Garth Butcher, St. Louis Blues, former captain. Got him on the 92-93 Fleer. And then is this 92 or 93 tops? This is 93 tops. I love the 92-93 Fleer. Blue Sharpie pops on this really nice.
2:25 left here in the first period. McSorley getting into it with Butcher, and the goaltender as play stops. Now here comes Diddick, but it's going to be Butcher and McSorley, the main event. Two of the tougher customers on their respective clubs, Marty McSorley and Garth Butcher, and they're squaring off.
Thank you, Garth Butcher. All right, we're going to move the envelopes and start our display up here. Next one coming out of St. Louis, Missouri, we have Rob Ramage. You kind of see his autograph blends in with the blue jersey there on Toronto. I think this was the later part of his career. He used to play for St. Louis, Toronto, then I think he got traded to the Stars this season. Yeah, you can see now with North Stars right there on the right side of the card.
Curvers, but it goes back of the net. Left there, Ramage is high stick and hurt.
Ramage is a pretty sensible player right here. And he is what happened.
Very upset. And Ramage is skating over to the towards the Detroit bench saying something. And he is saying something to Jacques Demers. He wants Demers.
Only had one card of his, so I sent it his way. He returned it signed. Thank you, Mr. Ramage. Small envelope number 3 coming out of Denver, Colorado. I think it's all going to be hockey cards. I don't think my baseball cards are coming back yet. I just shipped those out last week. This one we have Mr. Michel Goulet, former Blackhawk and Nordique. Yeah, both on the Blackhawk. So we have his highlight card here, Topps 93. And then we have his 1990 Pro set. Yep, 1990 Pro set. I actually prepped this one properly, so there's no smearing. Very glad this came out nice.
In front of the net, a shot scored! The shot by Goulet, a giveaway right in front of the net. And he hit the lower left-hand corner, 2-0, Chicago.
You were saying to me, Harry, today that Goulet has played very well in the recent game since coming back from injury.
Thank you, Mr. Goulet. Next one coming out of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Oh, it's out of the card saver, but it is Mr. John LeClaire. Oh, yeah, so he's $5 per. I wrote that on the card saver so I'd remember. Very quick return from Mr. LeClaire. Got him on the 93 tops in blue Sharpie.
Long shot by Bellows. Didn't get too far. Here's a chance for LeClaire. Oh, and a roll by the open side. He got another crack at it. He scores. The Canadians win the game in overtime. Time very early, 34 seconds. The Canadians won it.
Thank you, John LeClaire. Number 5 coming out of New Orleans, Louisiana. It is. Oh, he kind of used a crappy Sharpie there, but it's from Jeff Lazaro. You could see I did prep this card, but you could see he was using a pretty dull Sharpie.
Every 4 years, I bring out my ring. Bring my family into this room and tell them that their dad used to play hockey.
Backtrack 24 years to the 1994 Winter Games in Norway, where Lazaro faced some of the world's best.
they always say playoff hockey is the ultimate time of your life. Well, playing in the Olympics, everybody in the world is watching you.
Nonetheless, it is a return. Thank you, Mr. Jeff Lazaro. Next one, marked out of Reno, Nevada. It is Clint Malarchuk, former Sabres goalie. I don't know if you guys know the famous story of the goalie who got his throat slit open and continued to play following that injury, but that is Clint Malarchuk. If you haven't seen it, I'll post a clip, so viewer discretion advised.
On into the Buffalo zone, Mahar goes to the corner of the pass, and
that'll watch Malarchuk. That's the story right now with the rim. Oh, please take the camera off, but don't even bring it over there, please.
Oh, my God.
Just keep it away.
Oh, terrible.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Malarchuk. You played for the Nordiques, Capitals, and, of course, the Sabres. Last one, coming out of Carroll Stream, Illinois, we have... No, we got Chris Chelios. No fucking way. This came back fast, too. I didn't think I was going to get this back. I just kind of sent it out as one of those, maybe I'll get it back, maybe I won't. He signed both, I think. Yeah, both in black. You got the 93 Tops, and then is it the 92 Premier? 93 Premier, sorry. Like, this is the only Premier card I have. He signed both in black ink. Hall of Fame hit already.
In 1990, Chelios returned home when he was traded to Chicago.
Oh, Chelios hammered a man in the corner.
Chelios used his game of intimidation on any and all Blackhawks opponents.
And now Chelios has just lost it. Chelios and Larry Murphy.
He never made it easy on the opposition. A real hard-nosed guy that had a tremendous amount of talent.
He wasn't playing within the rules. He's going to play on that fine line. He knew what the edge was. He knew how to play on it.
10-11 day turnaround. He's a Hawks ambassador, so he's usually always at the games. Surprised he got that back so fast. Thank you, Chris Chelios. Blackhawks icon, Stanley Cup champion, Hall of Famer. All right, let's clear out all these ripped envelopes. Let's get into the photos. Just like last video, the large envelopes are not postmarked. I think occasionally, once in a blue moon, there's going to be one that goes through the scanner. But I'm just taking random guesses at these. I have no idea where they've been. So I got 5 returns in yesterday on 2-2-2-22, whatever, the Tuesday, with all the 2s in it for February 22nd, 2022. All right, so we have one from Valentine's Day, one from the 17th, one from the 18th, and all the rest of these are from the 22nd, I believe. Love these. These are so easy to open. Make your predictions, folks. Oh, it's in a top loader. Mike Arruzioni, no way. Team captain for the Miracle Team. And he put 1980 gold medal, I think. Yeah, he put 80 gold. Signed it right across his chest. He's shaking hands with the Soviet Union players. That is such a cool photo.
11 seconds. You've got 10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow, up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. It's over.
Thank you, Mr. Arruzioni. Starting off hot with the pictures. Next one, 217. Looks like I was sleeved. And it is Richard Petty. Richard Petty is a stock car legend. He drove the number 43 car. Saw he was signing. This came back pretty fast as well.
But a crash on the home stretch. A car upside down.
And that's
a
Richard
blue
Petty.
Car, it is Richard Petty.
I jumped off the score stand and started running as fast as I could.
I was working in the booth with Jim McKay for ABC. The position that he was in, it looked like blood coming out. It was a scary scene.
Sign it right up top there. Thank you, Mr. Richard Petty. Coming from 218. This one looks like it's been stepped on and, like, put through all sorts of shit. So hopefully there's no damage done to the photo. It is in a top loader. Oh, maybe not. Felt like it was in a top loader. It is. Oh, it's Olaf Kolzig. Holy shit. That was a fast return. This came back in, like, a week. So he signed the card that I provided for him. I also gave him a photo, which I'm hoping is here. Oh, he put it between the two. I didn't know I sent him two magazine backs, but he signed his photo on the Capitals, one of the better Washington Capitals goaltenders. And then I'll show you the card, top prospect card. I think this is 92 tops.
Towards the front, knocked out, and Jake off the post by Straka. Loses it, oh! No! Kolzik stopped it! What an Akita! I don't believe it!
He stopped that, baby, with the catching gloves!
You will never, ever, ever see a better stop than that.
The scramble in front, it hits the pipe, they throw it back in front. Kolzik's out of position, and there he is scrambling back and snaring that baby with his catching gloves.
Thank you, Ole Kolzik. Five big envelopes left. This one came in yesterday. Not in a top loader, but it is Mr. Bob Cousy, Boston Celtics legend. Says to Johnny, thank you for your interest, maybe? Bob Cousy? Thank you, sir. Either thank you for your interest or thank you for your words. Can't really make it out, but nonetheless, very kind return.
Now Bob Cousy, over to Richie Guerin. Pretty.
Incredible player. Large envelope number four. This is when I didn't have magazine backing, so I just used fucking random cardboard. Oh, Dana White. Dana White is the president of the Ultimate Fighting Championship.
All right, boys, we made a tradition with Uncle Dana. Every day has to begin with a howler head shot of whiskey. Every single day, we're going to meet here.
Yeah, right. Every day.
Cheers, boys. Love cheers
to 11 o'clock in the morning, by the way.
It's going to be a good week. Cheers.
If you need anything, let me know.
Thank you so much.
Dana, do you want to do another shot before you go?
Sure. I'm going to the gym. I'm going to work out fucking Steve style.
Cheers.
All right, brother.
Have a good workout.
He's the man. He's the fucking man.
Thank you, Dana. Down to three left. I'm going to show you on this one for some odd reason. I guess I owe 22 cents more on this one, but it's coming out of Renton, Washington. I feel like I know who this is. And if I do, it's going to be a big hit. All right. It is in a top loader. Oh, my God. Is it signed? Yes, sir. It is Mr. Warren Moon, quarterback for the Houston Oilers, and he put his Hall of Fame inscription down there as well. I think he was $10 per autograph.
When he would throw the ball, you would literally hear this sound come off his fingers.
Getting that precise sound required perfect nails.
Warren's more particular about his fingernails than a woman.
My fingernails had to be the right length for me to throw the football the way I wanted to, the way I felt comfortable. And when my length was right, my ball spun as well as anybody who's ever played the game.
So happy about that one. We got a little bit of a glare there. Maybe I'll take it out of the top loader. All right, this is one of the oddball ones that was postmarked. This one's coming out of Lubbock, Texas. I don't recall sending anything to Texas, though. So this is going to be a surprise for me. Let's see who we got. Oh, modern hit. Trevor Rogers, all-star pitcher for the Marlins. That's awesome. Take that out of the sleeve so we don't see much of a glare.
How about three in a row on the slider?
Be able to play like 45 minutes to an hour later. Another strikeout for Rogers.
Here's the Rogers.
Pro athletes holding an iPad make catches like that.
Swing and a miss. That's eight strikeouts.
Thank you, Trevor Rogers. Good luck on the season if it actually happens. All right. Last return of the day. See who we end on. It is in a top loader. Usually if I take the time to put it in a top loader, it's going to be someone good. We have Holy shit, we have Marty Broder. What a way to end it. Stanley Cup champion, one of the best goaltenders of all time. I kind of wish he would have signed it over the Stanley Cup, but that's okay. Shocked right now.
And everything happened so fast. You know, we went from a lockout to a 48-game season to the playoffs, and, you know, we haven't faced the Western Conference at all year. Next thing you know, we got to face one of the best teams in Detroit and, you know, turned around and we swept them in four.
The Devils have won the Stanley Cup!
Brodeur's remarkable play continued as he led the Devils to another Stanley Cup in 2000 and then a third in 2003.
That is an insane return. We had some good-ass returns today. That is a solid 15 right there. All right, and we have so many more photos and cards out right now. I did that huge baseball load from last week, so we should be getting all those back soon. Have a couple more hockey pictures out, I believe. Some hockey cards out still. Thank you, Mr. Martin Brodeur, Trevor Rogers, Warren Moon, Mr. Dana White, Bob Cousy, Ole Kolzig, Richard Petty, Mike Ruzioni, and then shout out to Chris Chelios, Clint Millarchuk, Jeff Lazaro, Michel Goulet, Garth Butcher, Rob Ramage, and John LeClaire. Still surprised we got that Chelios back too. That is a huge return. Like I said, if you like this idea, let me know in the comments. Also give me a like since YouTube took away the dislikes. And then go watch the first video I posted. We had some good returns there as well. And then if you want to learn how to do this, let me know. I could do a tutorial as well. Super, super simple. And I could show you where I get all the addresses as well. Stay tuned for more NHL 22. We're winding down on that. We're in the back nine of NHL 22. So probably going to get some more EASHL and be a pro. Then probably some more Fortnite soon. And definitely more of this right here. We're going to be stacked for the next couple of months. All right. Thank you for watching. See you next week.